Hello, I'm Ralph DeFronzo, and I'm professor of medicine and chief of the diabetes division at the University of Texas Health Science Center in San Antonio, Texas. Most recently, we've had introduced into the diabetes marketplace incretin hormone therapy. Hormones. And we have the BID exenatide, we have the once weekly exenatide, and we have the once daily liraglutide. Now, what do we know about incretin hormone physiology? We know that when individuals ingest a meal, that within several minutes of ingestion of the meal, there is a marked increase in GIP secretion by the K cells in the early part of the small intestine, as well as GLP-1 secretion by the L cells in the distal part of the small intestine and large bowel. Now, gastric emptying takes some 10 to 15 minutes, so it's very unlikely the nutrients are getting to the K cells, and for sure they're not getting down to the L cells. Nonetheless, GIP and GLP-1 go up within several minutes. We now believe that there are small numbers of K and L cells in the antrum of the stomach, and with distension of the stomach and passage of nutrients through these K and the L cells, there are neural impulses that go up to the hindbrain and the hypothalamus, and then back to the vagus to the K and the L cells, leading to the increase in GIP and GLP-1. Now, both of these incretin hormones, GIP and GLP-1, have a powerful effect on the beta cell to kick out insulin. And the beauty of these hormones is that they will kick out insulin only when you're hyperglycemic. When the blood glucose starts to come back down to normal, they stop working on the beta cell to kick out insulin, and this minimizes any associated hypoglycemia. We also know that GLP-1, but not GIP, has a powerful effect to inhibit glucagon. Of course, this is very important because we know that glucagon levels are elevated in our diabetic patients and are driving hepatic glucose production. GLP-1 also delays gastric emptying. This is important, particularly in newly diagnosed diabetics who have an accelerated rate of gastric emptying. So by slowing gastric emptying, we're actually correcting an abnormality that's present in our newly diagnosed diabetics. And with regards to glucose homeostasis and weight regulation, we know that GLP-1 is a potent appetite suppressant. And as you suppress your appetite and you lose weight, this leads to an improvement in insulin sensitivity. There are also now a number of preclinical as well as human data that are being generated that indicate that GLP-1 also has very important beneficial effects on the myocardium as well as on coronary blood flow. So the GLP-1 analogs are ideal agents for the treatment of our diabetic patients.